Hi guys, and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be showing you how to do wrist rigging on your blocky rigs for Roblox. This actually seems kind of hard because we've learned how to do normal arm rigging before, but you know, wrist and foot rigging can be a little bit difficult. So I'm going to be showing you the ways. So it has been 6 months since I last uploaded, and I was meant to come back with a big thing, but it's just not ready yet. So today we're going to be doing wrist rigging, just a simple, you know, tutorial just to gradually get ourselves back into the channel. Yeah, let's get started. As you can see, I've already rigged the arm right here. I've added the bends, everything. This is what it's like. Obviously, I've done the upper arm wrong already. So let me just fix that really quickly. This is what your arm rig should look like when you're making your blocky rig. And you might be saying, you know, how do I rig the wrist? Because it is just all the foot, obviously, this is the same thing with the foot. It is a lot more control over your poses, so I will be showing you that. So go into edit mode, and we're going to want to go into wireframe so we can see the loop cuts that we made. You know, you want to make sure you have 3 loop cuts. And what we're going to do is we're going to take the tail of the lower arm and move it up to here. Now, still selecting the tail of the lower arm bone, you want to extrude down right about here. Or you can end here, wherever you want, really. And we're going to name this hand, or in fact, wrist. Now, if we go into the vertex groups right here and we add wrist, .l, yeah, it doesn't do much at the moment, but we are going to rig it. So what you want to do first is just take a look at the weight painting just so I can explain what we're going to do. So we've assigned these weights to the upper arm and lower arm. We are going to remove the lower arm ones now. So what we're going to do essentially is we are going to remove all of them for the lower arm. So box select all these faces for the lower arm. And right here in the vertex group menu, remove it so that it's no longer assigned. Then press 2 or select the edges menu right here and select these edges here, these ones. Then assign that to the lower arm. So as you can see, that's what we got now. It doesn't look great because this is no longer rotating along with it. Don't worry, we are going to fix that. Now, if you haven't already guessed, for the wrist bone, we will literally just add in what's missing here. So edit mode, select these faces, already done it just to test if it works. So just select those and assign, and you will see smooth gradient, everything works, we're good to go. Now, as you can see, we've got a wrist, a working one. It looks nice. As you can see, the wrist looks quite nice and proper. It looks just like how it would in any other rig, really, that does wrists correctly. I didn't actually know this technique up until that recently, to be fair, and the reason why was because I wasn't doing this bone thing where I would move the bone up. Like, I really didn't think of how where your bone's origin is from matters. I would literally just have it down here and it would just result in this, which isn't nice. Now, that's for wrists, but if you are doing legs and you're doing a foot rig, you would want to just move this down for fancy feet purposes. It just looks nicer. If we toggle inherit rotation, you can see it's flat all the time. So you would want to move the bone down here, but for the wrist, no, we're not doing that. And it looks, in my opinion, way better this way. And if you're wondering why I didn't teach that in the How to Make a Roblox Rig series, it was because I simply just didn't know. Like, I think it's just a technique I hadn't learned then, but now I have. And yeah, this is how you do it. Hope this works for you, and I'll see you next time. Bye.